Are we starting? Are we starting, Chris? We're starting?
We're ready.
Hello, everybody. How you doing, Vapor Central? How the fuck are you?
It's the CK Podcast.
It is the CK Podcast. It's Monday, Easter weekend.
It's April Fool's Day.
April Fool's. How you doing, Trev?
Good, Cal.
You want to do the disclaimer before
we get going?
We'll
do the disclaimer. It's the CK Podcast. He's Cal Post. I'm K. Trevor Wilson. He's the C, and I'm the K. We are in no way, shape, or form affiliated with Louis C.K. or Calvin Klein Cosmetics and Wardrobes or anyone else who may actually own the trademark to the initial C.K. We are hoping to get some of their internet traffic.
All of it.
But we are not affiliated with them in any way, shape, or form.
I think we should get all their traffic. That'd be great.
That's the legal part.
Happy Jesus is back day.
Yeah, well, I guess that was yesterday.
So why does everyone get a holiday on Monday?
I don't know. This is... We get an extra day for Jesus. An extra day, because this is the day when Jesus went on his Easter egg hunt.
I wonder what Jesus did the day after he came back. Smoked a joint. Yeah, Jesus smoked a joint on Monday.
Rested up for moving that great big rock.
That could have been any fucking guy. I see guys all the time with long beards and long hair. They all look the fucking same to me. Anyone could have been in that fucking cave. Could have been just another guy. Like, hey, you're Jesus. Yeah, sure. Fucking right. Yeah, I'm Jesus.
I do think we need to get rid of the idea that Jesus looked like Eric Clapton circa 1974. Like, Jesus would not have been a white, blue-eyed guy.
Yeah, he would have been a black dude.
Well, I mean, at least he would have probably looked like a Middle Eastern Jew. Like, let's be honest.
Right.
He was a Jew in the Middle East. He probably would look more like an Israeli dude.
Yeah, if you're king of the Jews, you probably would look the most like one.
You know,
you can't be the king and not look like a Jew.
You're not going to look like a fucking Toronto hipster.
You can't look like George Carlin back in the 70s.
As most depictions of Jesus would have us believe. Like, he probably wasn't a white guy. At least not, you know, the white as white as they have him painted at churches.
Ah, fuck him, he's dead. What's he done for you lately? Nothing. Nothing. 2,000 years of nothing. Fuck him. Fuck him.
Cal Post, everybody.
Hi,
coming
I'm
out
actually,
with
I'm not
politically
angry
correct.
I'm not angry this week. Nothing pissed me off this
JC.
Week. I went through the news. The news is pretty awful. Other than that, but nothing infuriating. Not like the pandas come to Toronto.
How are the pandas more infuriating than a shooting in Yorkville?
Well, infuriating of... Why the fuck does anyone care? Like, that shit pisses
me off.
Okay. When I hear about somebody, like, that's sad. But when everyone makes a big deal out of fucking pandas coming...
Well, maybe they are rare.
Yeah, that's why they should stay where they're from. You can't cart the last things around the planet. Oh, look at this rare thing that's going to die. Yeah, you know what they're going to do? This fucking cracked me up. Because they're in Toronto. The pandas are in Toronto for 5 years. If they don't fuck...
Hurry down to the zoo, guys.
Yeah. You only have 5 years
to
watch
the pandas
maybe fuck. But
they are lazy animals sometimes.
Yeah, they fuck like once a year at a certain time. I didn't know that. They're completely opposite of me in every way. But
very similar to me, though. That's
you kind of look like a panda,
you know.
Except larger. So, if they don't fuck in 5 years, they're going to be put under anesthesia, and then they're going to artificially inseminate the male to the female, which is awesome. They're going to be roofied and raped at the end of this tour. How awesome is that? Welcome to Toronto at the end, roofied and raped.
I was just partying, eating some bamboo, and then I don't know what happened. I feel weird. You guys know what happened last night? I was just chilling with the giraffes, and then all of a sudden...
There's no other panda friends to cut in. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing to Ying Yang?
Did you do anything to me, Lei Ling? Like, no, I was I was knocked out, too.
Yeah, the male panda looks totally
But I had the greatest dream ever.
Oh, it's April Fool's, so it's not only is it... I don't know if anyone... Did you guys do anything for April Fool's?
It's the day of trickery that no one really gives a shit
about. But it's also Matt Oliver's birthday, an employee here, an awesome employee, so a big round for Matt.
Happy birthday to Matt Oliver!
Happy birthday, you fuck! Happy birthday. He's in the back doing stuff. You're welcome.
You know that the birthday song, the people who own the rights, that's not a public domain song.
No, you can't sing it.
Like, it costs a lot of money if you want to use the birthday song in any sort of public broadcast, which is why, you know, people end up writing shitty new birthday songs.
I'm going to write a new one. Fuck them.
I think it's probably cheaper to use the song from The Simpsons. You're the birthday, you're the birthday, you're the birthday, boy or girl. That's the cheaper alternative than using the actual birthday song. That's why you only ever hear like the last refrain in TVs or movies. They come in as they're going to you, and then so they're like, oh, they were just singing happy birthday.
Yeah, but you know, I like that they can't claim credit, but you know exactly what
you know
they
exactly
were.
What yeah. they were doing. I hope we don't get sued for that. Oh, no one's watching this.
I'll sing the whole goddamn song. I have nothing. What are they going to sue me for? I have fucking nothing.
Careful. They'll bleed. They'll try to bleed a stone.
Oh, also, before we move on, I want to say how great Kitchener, Ontario is. You don't hear that too often.
No, you
Kitchener,
don't.
Kitchener, Ontario is fucking awesome. I did stand up there last weekend, 4 sold-out shows, and they were amazing. They're all drunk and rowdy and crazy and fun.
Well, I can believe they were drunk in Kitchener.
Yeah.
That I can believe.
They get shit-faced. But
that is the home of Ontario's Oktoberfest. Formerly New Berlin. They changed the name during the Second World War.
That was smart.
Trying to distance ourselves from the Germans for reasons we're all aware of.
Hitler, probably, right?
Yeah, that would be the one.
Weren't they known as the old Berlin or New Berlin? Isn't that what Kitchener was?
Kitchener was New Berlin.
New Berlin.
Yeah.
Was it actually founded by Germans?
It was a heavy, heavy German population, and then the Mennonites also.
The Mennonites.
Oh, you Mennonites.
Jarring different
The
vegetables.
Mennonites
Good
are definitely
you.
Not watching the podcast. You no. weird Stone Age fuckers.
Fuck you, Mennonites.
I actually, there was a really interesting article a couple years ago that the Mennonites and the Amish had become very big in the drug smuggling trade.
Awesome.
Because people obviously would not think to search
a carriage,
a horse-drawn carriage for drugs. They were getting paid to carry drugs across the border.
All right,
the Mennonites, you know, belief was they're not selling it to our children, so fuck the heathens. And they were, you know, because you still need money, even especially, actually, probably especially when you live off the land without the advantages of modern farming machinery. They finally had to force the Mennonites to install lights in the back of their carriages.
Yeah. I don't like Amish or Men. I don't know. What's the difference? I don't even know the fucking difference. What's the difference?
Probably some slight religious belief that seems very insignificant to us, but is probably very important to those Stone Age lunatics.
I don't get it. I don't. You can live a simple life without having to be an asshole about it.
The belief that somehow any sort of technological advance beyond the wheel is evil is very stupid to me. Like, if you are going to believe that, you know, God grants the gifts, then wouldn't it be reasonable to believe that God granted people if you're going to believe in these things, that God made people smart enough to fucking invent shit?
I don't like it.
An airplane is a gift from God. Because he gave someone the brain power to fucking invent it.
Yeah, that's how I always thought about it.
Yeah, you know.
Here's something, because the evolution, people who don't believe in evolution are retarded. I can't have a conversation with them. But the world's only 6,000 years old, and God just made people, and boom, they were here.
The idea that they're like, oh, so you're saying I came from monkeys? Like, you're saying we came from a clump of dirt. Which is more believable?
That we grew
from another creature, or that we were just made from dirt.
The other thing too is that if
dirt,
if we were just made, if we were just made, like poof, why would we not be just as great as we are now? As soon as we arrived, why wouldn't we have iPhones and shit? the minute we got here. Like, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to make a fucking...
Well, like the Bible,
I'm going to invent the blowjob, and then I'm going to make an iPad.
The Bible also wants us to believe that people used to live 900 years.
Yeah, that's stupid.
And then we somehow lost that ability. They've come up with some fake scientific explanation that there was some sort of, you know, electromagnetic field at the time around the Earth affecting the age of people.
What happened to the electric field?
I don't know.
Magic.
Yep.
What else? You want to talk about April Fool's?
Yeah, let's talk a bit about April Fool's Day.
I just took some
shots. I'm kidding. I don't want to talk about it. April Fool's. No. yeah, go right ahead.
I was just thinking, because I don't do that anymore. I don't really pull pranks. I used to. You ever pull any good pranks? You ever pull any, like, fucking good ones?
No. Yeah, the best prank I ever pulled that I thought was brilliant turned out to be a horrible, horrible prank. And sort of scared me off of pranks forever. And it was just a simple one. My mom had to run into a store. I didn't want to go in, so I convinced her to leave me in the car.
Stole the car?
When she ran into the store, I climbed into the trunk and hid under a blanket. And so she came back, and I wasn't there.
Oh, that's really funny.
She was panicking, and I thought it was hilarious. I'm like, I was just like, I was holding in laughter under a blanket, like, oh, she's going to laugh so much when I pop out. And then I, like, jumped out, like, surprise, I was here the whole time. And my mom just started to cry. Like, just sobbed. She's like, never do that again.
Did
I
she
was
hit
so
you? Did she
scared.
Hit you?
And she just hugged me and cried.
Smacking
and
your, like, big melon?
I was like, oh, I thought you were going to laugh. I thought this was super funny. And no, I just, like, traumatized my mother. And
did you ever get spanked as a kid?
No, sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Well, I mean, not like...
You've got a wide area to take care of.
You know, like, I never got, like, severely beat. But, I mean, I'd get a good smack every now and again.
I got a few backhands.
And usually, you know, in retrospect, I was a mouthy, stupid kid. I probably did something to...
For some reason, I picture you as a kid with a beard still. Yeah. I don't know why.
Yeah.
I hate
when
your face.
I was a kid, I
hate,
like,
your face.
When I was a little baby, I looked like Ron Howard. Well, not a little baby, but when I was a little kid, I was just red hair, freckle-faced, running around in overalls.
See, here's why I don't do it anymore, because... I did it when I was a kid, but it was evil.
Well, I imagine you were an evil kid.
Yeah, and this is...
For some reason, I still imagine you as a child drinking scotch, so...
Every guy in my family. Anyway.
Just sitting there with a cup of
scotch. I'll just do the one thing.
Yep.
This is why I don't do them, because I thought they were hilarious, but no one else ever did. Which is great. When I look back in hindsight, I'm like, ah, fuck, what are you doing? What? Why? So the big one was I faked cancer. When I was in high school.
Oh, my God.
I know. It's fucking stupid.
That's almost gross.
But I sat down, like, three of my friends, and I had it all planned out. I told them I had lymphoma. I gave them dates for chemo, and I, like, just did it straight. And in my brain, I was like, this is the funniest. They all think I'm going to die. I don't know why I thought it was. I just, like, that evil streak. And then I pulled a, you know when I fuck off for, like, a week and I don't talk to anybody?
Yeah.
I get any. So one of those weeks happened right after, so I forgot to tell them that it was all just a big gag, a really big, dumb gag. So when I saw everyone again, like, a week later, they're like, how's it going? You gonna be, is everything going?
Oh, you're
anything
the worst.
I know, and I was like, oh, and I was just flippantly like, I was just, I made it up. And I got smacked.
Now,
oh, so many people were mad.
My art teacher in high school thought I had cancer, but that wasn't my fault. I was supposed to get a mole removed because it, you know, could potentially be cancerous one day. My doctor, like, took a look at it and was like, you know, there's nothing wrong with it now, but you should get rid of it as a preemptive strike.
Right.
And I was telling my buddies, oh, I have to get this done. But then I was actually away from school, I think for an audition. And my art teacher said, does anyone know where Wilson is? And my buddy's like, oh, yeah, he's getting a cancerous growth removed. And so I came back to school, I think it was like a Friday, so I wasn't back to school till like the Monday, and then my teacher comes up to me, and he's like, you weren't in class on Friday, and I was like, oh, and like I didn't want to say I was at an audition, because that's a bad reason to miss school, so I was like, oh, you know, I had some stuff to take care of. He was like, yeah, I know, I heard about it, and is everything okay? You okay, bud? Like, if you ever need to talk to someone, just let me know. I was like, oh, no, I'm fine, but thanks, sir. And I walk away. And then as I think about it, I was like, oh, my God. Why? And I asked my buddy, why is, you know, he acting weird? Did someone say anything? And my one buddy was like, no, he didn't say anything. And then my other buddy was like, oh, yeah, we told him you had cancer.
Jesus.
And I was like, you morons. You guys are idiots. You don't listen to anything I say.
I had surgery once when I was in high school, and I...
Bragger.
I had a buddy drive me to the hospital for it, so I was going to be gone for a couple of days. But I told him to drive back and tell everyone at school that I didn't come out of the anesthesia, that I was just in a coma. One buddy of mine, he went home and had this big, like, he was just bawling.
Why are all of your pranks plot lines from soap operas?
I don't know, man. I don't know. And they're evil. I don't know why I did that shit.
Did your evil twin show up at some point and wreck your life?
I shouldn't have. This is why I didn't have a lot of friends. This is why I had to move from friends to friend group. Yeah, it was fucked.
Because you were awful to your
friends. Yeah, I was just awful. I was an awful person.
You get them to care about you, and then you pull an awful prank on them.
I'm getting better. We've been friends for a while. I haven't pulled any weird shit.
That's true.
But I do hate you. I hate you so much.
I know.
I hate you.
It's because of my cherubic good looks.
All right, real quick. This is my favorite. This was my favorite all week. So last week on the Weedy Wednesday show here at Vapor Central. By the way, we're filming live from Vapor Central on the internet, everybody.
VaporCentral.com. If you're watching it, you're already here.
Boom. And a big round for Chris in the back, our producer, everybody.
Chris,
the guy who makes this
everyone.
All happen. Clap. Fucking clap. Everybody.
He's behind.
It's a lighter room tonight. It is the holiday weekend, so.
People
so anyway.
Have gone home or.
Last week at Vapor Central's Weedy Wednesday show, at the end of the comedy show, the stand-up show, they have a bong contest where two people dance for the bong.
Oh,
so it's a
dance-off. I heard
off.
About this.
It's a dance-off.
Well, no, I mean, I know the contest. I'm familiar with it, but I heard about what happened last week.
So we're going to pull up the video. Let's pull up the video. Let's just pull up the video and just show everyone what happened.
This is Hunter Collins.
Yeah, Hunter Collins hosting.
We need another competitor.
This is the regular length
so
version. I also have
compete for this
I shortened
bong,
it down.
Right up to the stage.
Yeah, we'll do that one after.
It's a nice bong. Nice big blue
I'll
bong.
Let this play through. And
some
then
ribs
click
at the end.
One.
Doubles as
this
a dildo for chicks
hosting
with
his last Weedy Wednesday.
Deep uteruses. So
Conan
Swedish
O'Brien
chicks.
Right there.
The Swedes.
Yep.
That is nice.
That's Hunter has
sparkly.
Never seen a bong
That's
before.
Sparkly.
No.
It looks like my face when I go to the club.
A couple sparklos on that. So you're in?
We need one more person to compete in the bong competition. Easy competition.
She
you
is
can
a
go
rock
home.
Star.
With Big Blue over here. This guy's challenging his buddy, saying, yo, be a man. Be a fucking man. Why don't you come, tough guy? Come on up. It'll be fun. Come on, dude. Let's go. Let's clap for this guy. Come on. Let's get him up here. Come on, buddy. Come on. Come on. Come on. We all want it. Yeah, there's a real man. A real man.
This guy, even more awesome.
This guy's like got balls like footballs. And you're a woman with the equivalent of big balls, which is like, I'm not even going to say it. It's disrespectful. It was going to be awful. Hey, one time I fucked a chick with a pussy so fat and swollen it looked like I was fucking the Rolling Stones logo. Thank you very much. Okay. I had to say it. I had to say it.
It's a good joke.
So this is how the competition works, just so you guys know. Have you seen one of these before? Great. Okay. Yeah, we were running them on the screens before. This fucking dude is still just fucking watching the screen the whole time. You've got, like, possibly the best seat in the fucking place. And you're like, fucking fuck this guy. Someone's on TV. I'm going to watch this show. Send this dumbass fucking guy with a gay mustache. Okay. So, here's how the competition works. One after the other, these guys are going to hit that bong, clear it. Hand me the bong, I yell, hit it, we play some fucking dance music, and these guys exhale while doing their best touchdown end zone celebration
you
dance.
You don't want to miss this, K-Trev.
No, I don't.
And then you
it
guys get to vote
see it over your
on
head
who
head.
Goes home with old fucking Bluey Blue here. And when I say you guys get to vote who does that, I mean, when I point and I'm like, hey, you guys think this guy won? I need you guys to clap and hoot and holler. I got to say this every week, because invariably I'm like, yo, you guys think this guy took it? And then everyone in the crowd just goes, yeah, for sure, that guy, okay. For that guy's the best. So fucking just be loud. All right, what's your name, man?
Raj.
We got Raj and?
Natalie.
Raj and Natalie. Okay, Raj, we're going to give you a cool weed nickname. You're going to be fucking El Spliffo. Okay?
I guess I didn't.
So you guys cheer for El Spliffo when he goes, all right?
In the video.
Yeah. You ready, man?
Hunter Collins is really ladies bad first. At making
okay,
up weed
right.
nicknames
Natalie, we're going to give you a fucking cool weed nickname, too.
El Spliffo?
You're going to be fucking.
I think he's reusing.
Bong Nanorama. That's you, man.
He's a bum.
You're fucking Bong Nanorama. All right? Let's cheer Bong Nanorama on. You ready? All right, hit
all right,
it.
Watch this.
Bong Nanorama. Bong Nanorama. Let's go. Cheer on, guys. She, come on. Give her some hope. Come on, lady. Hit it.
That was a full-on flash.
Oh, wait, wait.
Okay. The fucking sad part is I missed it. I was like... Thank you. There we go. Very good, very good.
I love how uncomfortable Hunter got.
You know how to charm your way into someone's spank bank. Oh, my God. Good Christ. These pants. I thought these pants were tight before. Hey, oh, whoa, hey, oh, oh, hey. Good God. Guys, we've seen some crazy shit during these bong competitions before.
That's up there with the backflip.
We just
guy.
Saw a pair of primo titties.
Best part of this video, best part. She doesn't.
Watch Mike
win.
Fucking show us his cock.
But she didn't really dance.
No, she didn't dance at all. But right out of the gate.
Yep.
It's like, I'll show my... She knows
I hope
she,
I miss
like,
it.
She wanted it. Like, I show
but you
my
never
tits.
Know. Raj, you're going to have to do something
like, no,
so
Raj,
fucking...
Came
you're
going
to have to, like, actually just, like,
this
think so hard and grow tits.
Just the best part is the guy in the corner, too, in the green shirt. Not... Didn't fucking move that whole time. Not
all
even
right.
tits.
Well, fuck it. Here goes.
Chair.
Ladies first, you gentlemen. Let's go. Hey, come on. Let's cheer him on. El Spliffo. Come on, buddy. You got this. Hit it, DJ!
I gotta say, he did put on the better show.
Yeah. And he was funny. That's why
I gotta give him credit for that.
He was funny.
So that was some entertaining dancing. He flashed too.
Oh, my God. That's crazy. That's crazy. Tit-wise tonight, we've seen,
now,
we've
had
seen
she
a pair
gone
of tens and a pair of zeros.
And flashed.
She would have won.
Would she have won?
Yeah, for sure, because he wouldn't have been funny.
All right,
he would have just done that bullshit.
Fucking vote time. See who goes home with Big Blue. This is going to be tighter, you know? I think we expected it was going to be.
Hunter's completely out
it's
of his element.
It's the craziest place
right now.
In the world.
Yeah,
I've
no
never
idea.
Seen
ladies
Hunter
and gentlemen,
this
who's going home with
words?
Big Blue? Is it El Spliffo?
Well, you would have been lost for words, too. I would have been lost. All right. What were we
or
doing?
Is it Bong Nanorama? Oh, my God. I'm sorry, but Raj is going home at the bong.
Hunter's got the best.
Big round of applause for both of these guys. Raj, way to go, buddy. Thanks again. Hit it.
Oh, they went. Okay, we just started the other video.
We got slow-mo.
Boom.
There you go, folks.
Hunter had the best line. Tonight you got to see tits and justice.
Well, that...
Oh, look at that. So slow, super slow. Hey, Chris, how many YouTube hits does that video have?
I don't know, like 1,000 or something?
Yeah, I'm like 850 of those for sure. For sure. That's all
so that
doing.
Was a crazy Wednesday.
Yeah, it was. There's guys who've done backflips and shit. Ah, The Simpsons.
Sweet, an episode of The Simpsons. We're the best podcast ever.
All right, you want to get into sports?
Sure, let's. Should we bring our special guest up for
yeah,
this one?
Yeah, we should. Yeah, we should.
Because he loves his sports. All right, you want to introduce him, or should I introduce him?
Yeah, our guest this week, just stopping in to talk and shoot the shit, is a world-renowned comedian. Might have seen him on Punk'd. Rob Pue, everybody. It's Rob Pue.
Rob Pue.
Clap your hands. Hey, Rob.
Wow, this is a tough act to follow, huh? Barely legal titties.
Yeah, I was so happy.
How do you lose? You can't. I don't care about his fucking dancing. Yes, it was entertaining. Those are barely legal titties.
I'm sure they were plenty legal.
Oh, just barely. Let me dream. God, those stood right up. She took her bra off and they fucking went up. Those were beautiful. Yeah. God bless her heart.
She just turned 18 that day.
Oh, God, that is the best thing you could have ever said right there.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
That was awesome. That was great. That was a great way to come up. Do some boobies and hey, let's talk sports.
It's sports time. Sports.
Sure. You had a big exciting week and then a disappointing end, kind of.
Yeah. I'm still kind of floating on cloud nine. Anybody didn't hear the Penguins acquired Joel Morrow and Jerome Iginla, or Brendan Morrow and Jerome Iginla. That's pretty sweet. Pretty fucking sweet if you're a Pens fan these days.
Yeah, you walked around with a boner for like 3 days.
Rock hard. Rock hard. 4.5-inch purple fucking diamond cutter I had sporting around in my jeans, sir. God, is that ever exciting.
Even the whiskey didn't piss you off.
No. There's no amount of spirits that could have made me angry.
When I saw you Thursday, which was, I guess, the day they officially announced it, because the Wednesday,
Wednesday
was like, he's going to Boston.
Yeah. It was even in the paper.
Like, ooh, he's going to Boston. Like, they were so sure he was going to Boston.
Yeah. How bad is the Sun, right? They print that article.
They're idiots.
Yeah, fucking idiots.
But then Thursday morning you wake up and he's a Penguin.
Yeah. Yeah, it was pretty. I had a one-word vocabulary for 2 days. Just, Iginla! Yeah, pretty excited about that, man. It's been fun to watch.
I remember
Sid took one in the chicklets, but whatever.
We have a tape of that.
Yeah. Got a tape of the kid taking one
I said
in the
mouth. The Loophole thing was first, but we do have a tape of Sid the kid.
When I read that happened,
I personally. Personally, I think this is because just you were celebrating too much on Thursday.
Yeah. That's the way it all works,
Sidney
right?
Crosby, you piss off the hockey guys.
Yes, that'd be the one.
Puck in the face.
Let me know when.
Yeah. Right now.
Anytime.
Are you guys going to be cunts and show the David Steckel hit instead? Oh, yeah.
Well, this is the season and the season series, but no goals. There's Orpik.
Right there. Right there. And there's a lot
really
of different angles.
Right under the chin.
Yeah.
Well, Crosby was able to.
That's okay.
Yeah,
show it again.
Season series, but no goals.
Fucking bang!
The kid
really
takes
high.
It like a champ. He gets up.
Yeah, take
Crosby
a puck in the mouth. What are you supposed to do, hey?
Escape.
Yeah, spit out your teeth and collect your pride. Get the fuck off the ice.
He took that puck like a champ.
Yeah, well, you can do that. Like, you or me or, you know, most people with no, like, huge dental plan would be just pissed, right? Now you're fucking, there goes any money you would have ever might have saved.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, for, like, the next 10 years.
Yeah.
He's covered, you know.
Buy a new car with that kind of dental.
He'll have that bread-selling smile back in the...
Oh, that kind of puck in the face puts me on the streets homeless.
Well, here's a slow-mo version of it. Just at the... I think that's where you can see his teeth.
Do we show the tits in slow-mo right after this? Does it make me feel better? Just right back to boobies.
Boom!
Puck in the mouth and then right to tits, and I'm okay with it.
Yeah. It's funny because it looked like he did. Oh, and that's the guy who hit him.
Yeah, Brooks. Yeah. He feels bad. There we go. Do the tits.
Here we go.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, sweetie.
That's
taking everything in me not to throw loonies at the television screen.
Rob, put your cock away. Put it away.
Polishing the helmet on the podcast.
How long is Sidney out with a broken jaw?
They said out indefinitely. I think he'd probably be gone about 3 weeks. It usually takes about 2-3 weeks. And then they put a big fucking helmet on you and let you get back in there.
So he'll just make playoffs then.
I'd be back a couple weeks before playoffs, it looks like, yeah.
They have done a good job of stacking their team, though.
Yeah, little all-star team they got going on.
The Pittsburgh Yankees.
The Pittsburgh Yankees.
Pittsburgh Yankees, I like that.
Well, that's the big joke. All my friends are all fucking Habs fans or Leafs fans, you know, so they're all making fun of me about, you know, a game like going there and then maybe not getting the chance to play with Crosby, which is the whole reason he's there in the first place. So.
The Leafs had a good week last week.
Wow, they ever lighten it up. Leafs, Leafs Nation's lighten it up.
We got a clip of Loopels. End-to-end goal from last week.
Beauty. Best goal of the week last week, Joffrey Leupel.
This is
coast to coast. Loupel shields the puck efficiently. Clear the track.
Looks for a skating room and finds some to his liking. Loupel across the line. He's driving
just
the net.
Holy
mackerel!
This is just a regular season game. My God.
That's a one-man team.
I could do that.
He just did all the work himself.
Yeah.
Well, Loupel took this team on his back
has been,
on Tuesday.
Since coming back from a broken forearm.
Coast to coast.
He's been on fire.
On steroids, yeah. He's been on steroids. He's been amazing, yeah. They look good, man. It's a good-looking team this year.
And Nazem Kadri last week got his
natural hattie.
Natural hat trick. I don't have a video of the hat trick, but I have we got a video of Don Cherry celebrating with Nazem Kadri after the
insane Don Cherry
after the game. Just a quick clip.
Yeah, with McLaren and Orr.
If we can Chris pull that one up. Don Cherry. Now Don Cherry gets flagged for being a racist, but I think this time he's proved he's.
He doesn't get. He is a racist, therefore he gets.
Yeah,
flagged.
Therefore he gets flack for it. Yeah. But yeah. He did a very non-racist thing.
You make it sound like the flack's undeserving. It's very deserving.
He just kissed a brown guy, so there you go.
All right, Lisa. He didn't kiss him. He kissed a hockey player.
Sure. And the Simpsons. Hey.
There we go. Right on. Yeah.
So good week for the Leafs. Pretty good week for the Pens.
I hope the Leafs don't make the playoffs. Really do.
You're such a cynical fuck.
It's almost an impossibility.
Comedy
no,
is so
good.
Shit when they're in the
It'll final. Be great. Well, it's been, what, 8 years? Let them fucking have some glory here. It'll
All
be
right.
nice to see them play. Get knocked out in the first round anyhow. What are you going to do?
But the Habs, who everyone thought was going to be shit.
Ah, fuck them. They can all rot.
But they're doing great, aren't they?
I hope Montreal turns into one big sinkhole. Aren't those fucking frightening, everybody? Apparently, sinkholes now. We can stop worrying about Armageddon, but you can't stop worrying about your apartment being swallowed by just a giant fucking hole in the ground.
Hey, they had a big one open up in Montreal.
Yeah.
They've had a ton in Florida.
Yeah.
That guy just, his whole, he was lying in bed and got eaten by the ground. It's like the opening sequence of Tremors. It's fucked up.
Top 10 ways you get a pick to go. No way sinkhole is in there.
Yeah.
No.
It scares people that are afraid of heights, right? Because you could live on the ground, but then all of a sudden you're really fucking high because there's no ground anymore.
I think the thing when the ground opens
you
up.
You can't trust the ground.
Yeah.
When the ground opens up to you, automatically.
That's a tagline for a horror movie.
You can't
what do you do when you can't? Where do you go when you can't trust the ground? Sinkhole.
Yeah, right after.
Starring
Piranha,
Kevin Bacon.
Right after Piranha 4.
I think when the ground opens up, though, you have a natural immediate response to think hell.
Yeah.
That's where hell is.
Yeah.
No.
Suffer is probably pretty cold and wet down there.
Oh yeah.
You have to go really deep for it to get hot again.
Yeah, really. Yeah, right to the planet core, that kind of sinkhole. It's just tight enough to just swallow your apartment perfectly standing up straight.
Ways to die. We talk about death a lot on this show.
Yeah, sure.
Constantly.
Ways to die.
Well, you know, it's a part of life.
Well, Easter was just the thing. That's the thing, right?
It's a big death holiday.
Easter. There's a lot of death going on with that. And
a lot
coming
of
back,
solemn.
Too. The old coming back part.
Death and resurrection.
Yeah.
I think it was just a guy. Just another guy who looked like him.
What a wicked trick that'd be.
You know what they say about the Jews? They all look the same. They all look... I don't think
no
anyone
one says
no,
that.
No one says that. Cal Post
I
says
said
that.
Cal Post said that.
Cal Post, he says. He says to a guy.
You can take the boy out of Trenton.
Yeah, I'm from the country, so what?
He's from Wooler.
I'm on meth.
It's super racist there.
All right, so any predictions for the playoffs in hockey? Who's going where and the what?
I don't know until...
I know you've already made bets.
After trade deadline's over, then we'll talk more about that, I guess. But, of course, I got my boys favored to win, but Chicago looks good. Leafs might make a run. You never know. Boston's still out there. Fuck, there's a lot of good teams, man.
My prediction right now is Chicago Pittsburgh in the finals.
Yeah, it's a pretty safe bet, I think. Them or Anaheim or Minnesota even. Yeah, she's a tight race. She's a tight race. There's going to be a lot of drinking done, and I'm going to ignore my girlfriend for like a month and a half. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, because you've never been with her during hockey season.
No, never been with her during hockey season.
She's going to fucking murder you.
Yeah, she's going to kill me. I warned her, though.
Right, picture behind you as you watch hockey, like yeah. Holding a crying baby.
It's the only time I can shush her, and she's not allowed to get mad.
That's an agreement.
That agreement. I'm just shush. You gotta be careful. You can't shush the old lady. Sometimes she'll smack you.
Yeah, I'm surprised you get away with calling her the old lady.
Yeah, well, she's not listening, so that helps. She's raising our child, so she's at home raising it.
It's our child now?
Yeah, it has to be.
You goddamn hero.
I wiped its asshole. Now it's mine. My child. As soon as I wipe your ass, you belong to me. That's my rule with any person.
That's a good rule.
Never be an orderly in a hospital. Just wiping asses and owning people.
You're mine. Yeah. You're mine.
Yeah.
Now, speaking of playoffs, the fantasy pool playoffs started this week.
Woo!
So how'd the season go? Where'd you end up in the season?
Oh, I finished number one, baby.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah. I'm on a bye right now this week. I don't have to worry till next week.
Word is on sitting the street. Pretty. You got a lot of help from El Rabo.
No.
Nope, never happened. Not one word.
This has been blown slightly out of proportion, probably by Ryan Horwood.
Yeah, yeah.
Old pouty
Ryan Horwood. trying to come up with an excuse as to why I beat him in my first ever hockey pool.
Sitting at a bar somewhere now, Rob and I, head in his
Captain
hands.
Hyper Bowl.
Rob and I, when we'd hang out at shows, just quite often, would talk hockey and talk fantasy pool. Rob would give me a lot of tips and send me the names of some players to keep an eye on.
That's cheating.
No, that's just talk.
Just talking. Insider.
Money's involved.
It's not insider. It's not like I'm fucking...
Insider, yeah, like I'm in the rink.
Yeah, but a guy who has every package to every sports channel.
Yeah, wow.
So does Horwood.
So is Horwood.
But Horwood's an idiot. Come on. That's not even fair.
I told Horwood, you know, actually one of the things that really helped me was talking hockey with Rob. And Horwood took that as to... be that Rob made all of my choices for me and selected my team. I was like, no, Rob and I just talked hockey. Rob is an encyclopedia of hockey knowledge and therefore was able to, we were able to have great conversation.
Yeah. Ryan
and he did offer insight that, you know, other guys wouldn't have.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of the guys that Rob suggested to me had already been taken.
Yeah, that's
you know,
true.
They were already picked up. But and after my choices were made, I would run them by Rob.
Yeah.
And but I put together the team.
Yeah, we talked about it for like 3 weeks after you put it together. It was always good looking. You got away with the two Hawks tenders, which is a big one in your pool. If you're in the fantasy league in the rotisserie and you got those nine columns to be judged on, then you got those four goaltending stats are massive.
I snagged up Crawford and Emery, and I did that on the first day. I did that on draft day.
Yeah, that's smart. Right there, you're looking good.
Last time I talked to Horwood about his pool, he was crying because all his guys were injured.
Literally crying.
Yeah.
Oh, my guys. No, he gets real. He'll get really
upset.
Then
he bought $1 million.
He's got a big heart.
Shots.
That guy, he's got a big
heart.
He
bought shots for everybody.
He's
a wonderful guy, but he does not handle losing. He handles losing as well as he handles us making fun of him.
I just like making fun of him.
Who in the world likes losing?
No one likes it.
No.
I've become pretty comfortable with it.
Yeah, oh yeah. You've lost a lot, have you?
But I mean, like, there's losing and not liking it, and then there's losing and writing a message to the, you know, commissioner of the league to give
who's
him more.
Just some guy.
To give, yeah, who's just Joe at the bar.
Yeah.
To give him more injured reserve spots so he doesn't have to drop players.
Yeah, because he was so injured. Yeah. His heart's broken, man.
It's a tough one.
Leads him to serving up Jameson's, which we all love, and giving out 10-minute introductions to sets at the Crown and Dragon. 10-minute intro for you. This next guy, he's got a first name and a last name.
He does love being loved.
Yeah.
When people love him, he couldn't be more thrilled.
Yeah. Good kid. Yeah, good kid. Like the cut of his chip.
Gets the puck out of the corners.
Check him out on Cash Grades every Saturday, 6 o'clock on YTV.
There you go.
Give him a little plug.
There you go.
It's the Amazing Race for kids, if the Amazing Race never left Toronto.
So I'm going to take out of this that Slackjawed Crosby's dead. He's probably dead.
Yeah, he's probably dead.
They're working on cloning him, engineering his growth, so he can be back in 3 weeks.
They just take him off a hanger in the closet somewhere and fucking throw him out.
Mario Lemieux's closet, he opens it up. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, either way, he's coming out of a closet. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, he's a big fruit.
He's just a Lemieux
Maybe
clone.
Maybe he is. Then he'd be the best one ever at anything.
Lemieux genetically engineered a new Lemieux.
Yeah.
And sent him to Nova Scotia to be raised.
Yeah.
And then brought him onto the Penguins.
Yeah, that's what happened. It was all genetic experimenters. Yep. They got Nazi scientists working for them in the basement of console.
He's got part Lemieux, there's some Gretzky in there, some Bobby Orr sprinkled in for good measure.
Right. No Bob Orr there, man. That guy's just a beast. Got a head like a cinder block, that old bastard.
How's Ovechkin doing? I haven't paid any attention.
He's gotten uglier somehow.
A fucking American Werewolf in Washington. That guy is homely, man.
That guy is so lucky he is a world-famous hockey player.
Yeah.
Because, fuck.
And he's crushing some female tennis star now, right? Like, they're married. They're married.
That's awesome.
Yeah, just going to build some superhuman.
Get really, really good at something and make a ton of money, and it doesn't matter if you look like fucking Frankenberry. Someone hot will fuck you.
Frankenberry.
I love that he drinks Coke during the game.
That explains why he's got no fucking teeth, that and the hockey. But
yeah. Drinks a bottle of Coke during the game.
Oh. So did you guys have a good holidays or what?
Yeah.
There he is. Oh, look at him.
God. Look at that homely
bastard. That's actually
bastard.
A good picture of him, though. There we go. That's the ugly fuck we all know.
Oh, God. Jesus Christ. You can catch Alex Ovechkin every night chasing cars down the 401.
You got to keep the mic pointed away from the
From the speakers. Yeah, yeah. There you go. Yeah, he's just a homely fuck. That's all I was trying to say.
Yeah.
What time are we at here?
Right on.
He does look like when the guy's halfway in between transforming an American werewolf, though.
It just stopped mid-mutation. Didn't take.
Didn't go full lichen. Just part lichen.
An underworld reference.
Alex, the dog-faced boy. No, but a great hockey player at one point.
Yeah, he's still good. He's still having a decent season for normal human beings.
You notice that Crosby versus Ovechkin debate isn't...
That's over now.
...isn't quite as big as it was years ago.
Yeah.
Who's going to be the greater player?
There's lots of great ones out there. Holy fuck! He looks like Jaws.
He does look like Jaws. That's amazing.
That's a great pick. Put the steel teeth in his mouth.
He's also from Happy Gilmore.
Yes, he played.
And I'm going to see you in the parking lot.
Hey, shooter.
I had to shoot the ball off Frankenstein's big fat foot.
Good times, you guys. We're having fun.
Do you want to talk about baseball at all? Because apparently the Jays are phenomenal.
Yeah, I hear it. I'm not a huge baseball fan. They're fucking
season
stacked.
Openers tomorrow.
Yeah, that should be good. Is it here in Toronto?
It's here in Toronto.
Well, that'll be great. That'll be great.
That
the city's
stadium
be
will
nuts.
Be that stadium will be full for the first time in 20 years.
Yeah, no doubt. No, it's gonna be bumping in there. It'll be fun. Hopefully, they could probably close up the dome for tomorrow. And hopefully,
I can only assume. I don't think it's quite mild enough for baseball yet.
No, 10 degrees, or I think they're looking at least, you know.
It was minus one when I left the house today. So
don't drive downtown tomorrow is what you're saying.
Yeah, I'm not going anywhere.
No
driving downtown tomorrow.
The Gardener's going to be a fucking shithole.
It is a shithole.
All right.
But
I think
it's more so than usual.
I think it's time to intro our newest segment.
Let's do a
which
segment.
I'm very happy about. All right. Okay, so here at the CK Podcast, we've been accused of not being fair to women. Being unkindly, even almost sexist. So
what?
I know, and it's not true because we are.
I have not heard these accusations.
It's just
I made them
unfounded
up. It's actually
bullshit.
Not true. Yeah, it's not true. We're very strong supporters of equality and
tits and vaginas and
yeah,
stuff?
Yeah, I think they're just as great as men, K-Trev. I think you can agree to that.
Hells yeah.
Men and women are completely equal. So in respect to that, we introduce our newest segment, Women We Want to Punch.
Women We Want to Punch.
Do we have the opening video?
We sort of need the graphic.
Yeah, we got a little graphic video.
We could throw up that snooki.
Ladies and gentlemen, Women We Want to Punch.
If you could just get away with slugging a broad.
Yeah, we're not saying. Oh, we
don't
just
go
wanna,
out and do it. By
yeah,
any
don't do
way.
It.
We're,
don't.
We're not saying go out and be violent towards women.
Right, but in
that's
a perfect world.
But in a perfect world,
that's truly equal,
where everyone was equal. There's a couple ladies that need a good smack
of
the chop.
They gotta fucking beat.
Oh, there we go. Like a blizzard. When we drink, we do it right.
Oh, wow. Well, I was just feeding her. And Bobby Probert is feeding her. Eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it.
That back. Jesus.
Oh, and then he gets jumped by 9 guys and
yeah, of course.
Just boot screwed, of course, I should hope so. And The Simpsons.
And The Simpsons.
So we've put together a list of 15 women that we
well,
want to
punch.
Well,
we each put together a list of 5.
Yeah, we each have our 5. I mixed them up, though. They're in no particular order.
It's really hard to come up with all of these.
So if we get the first picture up, please, the first woman we want to punch is Oprah Winfrey, everybody.
She's got it coming. She's got it coming.
She needs a, I don't know.
Why Oprah Winfrey? Because you could blindfold yourself and take a random punch in the dark and still catch head. No way she's bobbing out of the way with that fucking watermelon.
That, if you punch
that
her in the
thing is massive.
If you punch her in the head, there's a career in it. You're writing a book after you punch her in the head.
Yeah.
Why do you
you're
want
rich.
To smack her?
Yeah. Why? What's that?
Why though?
Why? Because it's giant.
Oh, just for the challenge.
It's the best. It's like one of those. What's one of the boppets? You know, you used to blow up that clown and you would fucking hit it and you
she's
just.
She's a
couldn't.
Tough broad. I bet you she. Could
I
take
bet
it.
You she'd come back too, and that's half the fun.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
You
sure.
can't just have an untouched, an you know just a just. Go all out on.
She
so
turn her rings around and just snap you back.
Yeah, she's been working out with all that Harpo money. That's just her name.
Southern
backwards.
Oprah comes out.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. right. Yeah, well, you know, she's probably got it
who's
in her. She's got a little fight in
list.
Her.
All right, the next one on the list
Oprah's
is
a fighter.
I don't know who that is.
That's Casey Anthony.
I know nothing about her. I don't want to punch
that's
her.
The, Casey that's the chick
yeah.
who killed her kid and got away with it.
Oh, yeah, punch yeah. her in the head.
Well, that's
sure.
a good reason.
She
that's a
murdered
good
a fucking
one.
Child. I'd wow. like to fucking throw an elbow at her.
Oh, easy.
Flying elbow
ground
off the top
and
rope.
Pound. Double leg scoop, sideways fucking suplex, fucking feed her.
Head to mush.
You guillotine. You gave her the easy way out.
She I just wanted to punch that stupid look off her face.
Yeah,
that
what an asshole. She's an asshole.
Is it ironic she's showing the peace sign? Is that...
Yeah, it's mildly ironic.
Peace, yeah. except the children.
She's right. actually going, she's actually going, cuckoo.
Yeah. All right, the next one, please. Elizabeth Hasselbeck from The View.
Oh.
Who
this
is
woman
one of
is so wrong all the time.
Wrong and dumb and dumb and wrong.
This is the woman who supported the waterboarding.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And she's against gay marriage and gay rights.
Yeah. I'm just against marriage in general.
I want, if anyone could hit her, I want Obama to smash her.
Oh, that'd be sweet.
He was on The View and she was trying to grill him.
Oh, yeah.
I'd love to see Whoopi just fucking reach across the table and fucking smack her.
That's almost like a man punching a woman.
I bet you Whoopi knows how to fight.
Yeah, talk to Ted Danson about that. I'm sure he's got some stories.
Who's next?
Who's next?
Carla Homolka.
Carla Homolka,
easy. Easy.
Now, if you don't know why we'd want to hit Carla Homolka, read a book.
What's that?
Well, it's people we want. It's a lady you want to hit. Right?
Yeah.
You
yeah.
want a punch in the mouth, right? So we're doing good here. She makes the fucking top 5.
No. We're going to do that in a later time. This one's just women we want to punch.
Okay.
Yeah. No, this is... we paid for her fucking college education while we was in prison. Now she's living in the Caribbean.
That's
and
right.
And apparently has 3 kids.
Oh, good.
Thing is, if you punch her, you better lay her out because...
She'll talk you into cutting people's feet off, apparently.
Yeah. who knows what she'll fucking do to you afterwards.
That's one mental. Sick fuck.
She's
next
like
picture.
The Hannibal Lecter of the ladies up here.
Next
else we got?
Photo. Next. Ah, Snooki.
We already saw her get blocked, but
she's been beaten up enough, hasn't she?
Just for pure irritation purposes.
Oh, wow. Hate the Jersey Shore.
Well, she's got a this face you could carve a roast on.
Yeah, we should have put the whole cast on. Like one punch to run through all of them.
This wow. You'd crack a knuckle on those cheeks. Look at that.
This is the representation of the dumbing down of North America.
She's got like big implants in those cheeks.
And yeah. She's raising a kid.
No way.
Oh, yeah, this woman's dumber than sand. Yeah.
I don't think I'd punch her. I'd karate chop her, though. Karate chop the shit.
I would pay money to see you karate chop Snooki.
She feeds her kids energy drinks in a baby bottle. She's just that kind of dumb.
Is it going to be the old Star Trek karate chop to just like the side of the neck?
Judo chop!
Yeah, and then the double fist fucking wah, down on the back.
She'd be one of those women I'd want to learn the Falcon death grip. Not the one that just puts you to sleep. Yeah. Like anytime she starts, good night.
Who's next on the? Who do we got next? This is Diana Medley. This is the Indiana teacher, or I guess she's like a school counselor, a special ed teacher, and she was campaigning to have a straight only prom.
Oh yeah,
because she doesn't believe gays are people.
What? Really? There's people out there like this.
They
look
like
introducing
people.
Me
well,
to
she
these.
Works in a, like, she works in a school.
She looks like she has a giant reptile living inside of her.
She doesn't think, you know.
She's
she doesn't want gay people part of the prom.
Idiot.
Yeah.
Well, who's that's a shitty decorated prom. Yeah, I'm telling you that right now.
Yeah. There will be no.
No, there's no balloons.
No one's
going to
spearhead
no
the
streamers.
Decorating committee.
That's bullshit.
And who's going to build it if you don't include the lesbians?
Yeah, I don't even want to be there. The playlist is going to be shit.
Do we have any more gay stereotypes to make this prom better? Is there any?
Next.
Next. Oh! This is
the Crypt Keeper.
Yeah, this is that bitch from Titanic. That old bitch from Titanic who kept the jewel that whole time. They go down to the movie, they go down to look for the jewel. She's not even a real person. This is why it's fun to punch her, because it's not even real. You can't even get the chance.
In the movie, that's her for real, isn't it?
That's her for real, yeah.
They spent all this money going to look for the jewel, and she was holding
it. She just had it the whole time, and at the end, she fucking throws it into the ocean.
That was the most erotic moment of my life.
Every guy in the world.
That's worth millions. Like, Bill Paxton should have flew from off screen and just fucking right in the face.
There was
across the room. Boom!
There was another version where they stopped her from throwing it over the side.
Like three guys tackled her.
Yeah.
Broke her
Bill
hip.
Paxton and the daughter, because they thought she was going to jump.
Yeah.
And then they realized she was just chucking the thing. But that was an alternate. All right, who's next?
Who's next?
Oh, Nancy Grace.
That's easy.
Nancy Grace.
This woman
another
is
easy one.
An yeah. awful harpy.
Yeah. Kick right to box. Night.
That's the face I hope
graduated.
She's making as I fucking punch her. Like,
Rob's
what are you doing? Wham.
Rob's graduated from punching to kicking in boxes. Yeah. Punching's not good enough anymore.
No.
I can't watch your program without getting furious, because this woman, I've never seen someone completely call people guilty before anything close to a trial happens. Like,
I think she has an unborn fetus caught in her teeth.
Oh, terrible.
She's an awful.
Just
heartbeat.
Be glad I didn't throw up the picture of her nipple slip on Dancing with the Stars.
Oh, no. Let's show the other one, though, again.
Who's next?
Oh, this.
Yikes.
Yeah, this is Arnold Schwarzenegger's maid, the one he had a kid with.
Ah! Friend.
So I just want to punch her for ruining one of the greatest action heroes ever. Potentially
making
ruining.
Him great again.
It's like you tried to ruin this guy, and he's awesome. That, and she could take a few, you can tell. But she was with Arnold, so he probably
has.
Oh,
wow. Well, that is Arnold, I'm sure, just with tits.
Imagine what their kid looks like.
Oh, God.
Alexander Ovechkin.
I really thought if he was going to...
Giant head on a giant body.
If he was going to knock up somebody, it would be, you know, it's like...
She looks like Rocky Dennis from Mask. Anybody seen that?
I think Arnold paid for those tits.
Yeah, oh, it must have, right? He had to be in the bank for a few bucks.
I can't have you cleaning my home with
no tits.
How
do you cheat on a Kennedy?
With that?
Yeah, no doubt.
Maybe she's a really good person.
Kennedys were due to be cheated on.
Probably a really nice person.
Probably a lovely lady.
Ah, but punch her. Punch her!
Who's next?
Who's next? Oh!
Judge Judy. She's got a fucking shit kicking coming, this one. You would have to peel me off of this woman. You'd have to stop the fight. I wouldn't know how to quit. Just keep punching until the floorboards are wet. I can't fucking stand this bitch.
You'd have to tune her hockey stick.
I don't know what it is about her just condescending shitty fucking attitude and her bird like head con at everybody. I just want to kick her right in the yap. I just would feel no remorse about it either. As the bailiffs cart me away, I'm like, I got it out. I had to do it. I'm glad I did it.
She's all punch drunk. Contempt. Contempt.
It's just spitting teeth.
Not in my court.
Contempt.
Hey.
Yeah.
What was that?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm thinking about committing a petty crime.
I bet
just
she'd
so I can get on the show.
I bet you she'd be ready for you, because I'm sure guys have tried.
Yeah. Well, she's a centaur, right? Like, so from behind there, she comes up. She's got a horse's backside.
The amount of guys that have, like, her show, when
she's
they
got
do
a gun under that under that desk.
Oh, yeah. The amount of guys after her show that do those little testaments afterwards.
Oh, yeah.
That she's like, fuck you, you're gone, and they didn't even get to talk, and they're just in the back, like, if I ever see that fucking bitch.
She better head out the back.
She's got moves, man.
She's got bodyguards. She has to. There's people's wanted to rush her for a long time. Since she was a little girl, people have been wanting to swing at her.
She was also a regular judge at one point, not just a TV.
Not just a cunt.
Who's next?
Oh, Kesha. That's an easy one.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be... You got to get your hands dirty with that
she's
one.
She's outsold the Beatles.
Ugh.
No, what?
What?
Yeah.
No.
Get out of here.
I'm not even making that up.
Is there any way you can find that stat? That is the saddest thing ever.
You can look that up. This is...
Kesha. Outsold the Beatles.
Kids, where do kids get all this fucking money from that Kesha has outsold the fucking Beatles?
You steal from your parents because no one hits kids anymore.
Ugh.
Yeah, they just give them money to go away.
That's
the new parenting.
Next time we'll have you on and we'll do kids we'd like to hit.
There's a lot of those.
Macaulay Culkin and Kieran Culkin, number one and two.
Oh, we'll just put up the whole family, fuck it.
Yeah, the Culkin family. Families you can punch. Anyway, this bit's got legs.
Next up.
Oh, Barbara Bush.
Barbara Bush.
Just for making one of the stupidest men on the planet president.
This is your son?
Yeah. This is what you did? This is the best you could do?
Yeah.
What, was he on the second or third try?
This is what that gnarly biscuit ears spat out into the world.
I still remember when George Bush Sr. was president, and I thought that was George Bush Sr.'s mom. I had to have it explained to me that he was married to that woman.
They have to thaw her out so they wheel her out on stage. And
she looks like a sweet old lady, but... She raised George W. Bush, so...
She sure did.
Shh, I'm ruining
the
planet.
In her volcano
I'm
of
ruining.
A vagina, she baked that fucking demon piglet.
Oh, man.
Who's next?
You go inside her twat, it looks like the inside of an alien ship. Just
smells like sulfur.
To the wall.
Justin Bieber!
Yeah,
Justin
this is Bieber. A this is a chick I'd like to punch.
I'd love to punch this woman.
This chick needs a slap in the chops.
Apparently,
he was keeping a pet monkey, too. The Germans took it away from him.
Good.
Oh, God. That's unnaturally pink lips.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Get that ugly broad off the television.
Did we not learn our lesson with Vanilla Ice? It's the same thing over again. Just fucking brutal.
I don't even know who these guys
are. Or these two guys.
Yeah, let's punch these two guys. I don't know who they are, but I hate them.
Are these guys in the corner?
Hi, guys in the corner. I didn't mean it. Don't hurt me. I'm a big pussy.
I don't know why the camera was aimed at those two.
That's really funny.
Oh, here we go. And the Queen of England. You got to punch the Queen of England.
Yeah, you got to.
If we're going on a lady punching spree,
if you get a chance,
lady.
If you got to punch a chick, why not be the Queen?
You know?
royalty, right? You're never going to say, I punched the queen. That's the best fucking story.
They've been living
ever.
Off of the British taxpayers. They do nothing. Literally nothing.
The most powerful
woman.
They
take British money, throw stupid parties, raise fucking... Oh, man. I mean, I thought Charles was a waste of fucking skin until Harry started taking his clothes off in Vegas.
Ugh.
First he shows up to a party dressed as a Nazi, and he's naked in fucking Vegas. Your grandson's a real
look at all those teeth.
Gem.
Look at all those teeth.
Oh yeah, they got to put peanut butter on her gums to get her to talk. This fucking horse. Look at that. If she tried to punch her in the mouth, she'd probably catch your fist with her teeth.
Just a bunch of inbred anger.
My grandma
anger.
Would be so That's what upset it is, with yeah. me right now. See me talking about punching the queen.
The most powerful woman with no power.
My grandma was quite the regophile. Yes. Do we have anyone else? Who's next?
I don't know if
we close
else.
With the queen.
Oh, Brian, our good friend Brian.
Babs.
Our Auntie Brenda, as we like to call him.
Is that his headshot? That is lovely. Yeah.
That is Brian Hatt. $11 jeans, best ass in comedy.
Hey.
How's it going?
He's going to take exception to this now that I think of it. That'll be fun to hear it from
this
him.
This is
next
not funny
week.
To
this
anyone.
This is actually the guy I want to punch the least.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, he's a good broad.
He's a broad. That's the best way.
He's a lovely broad.
It's a great broad. Good.
Dame Hat.
And I think that's it. Thank you for tuning in to Women We Want to Punch. Big round of applause to all those awesome women.
Again, we're not saying we want to hit all women. But we're saying if there was a world.
We want to hit 15 of them.
If you had five.
Yeah.
If you had five clean hits.
Yeah. Oh, we didn't throw up Ali's daughter.
Who? Oh, Muhammad Layla Ali.
Layla Ali.
Well, that's it. You got to.
You punch her if you want to die.
Yeah, you get in a fight then, you know, if you want to get in a fight.
That would be like throw, you know, Layla Ali or Ronda Rousey. You're not just hitting someone, right. You're brawling with them.
Hey, Sam, how's it going, Sam? What do we got
Sam.
Here?
Mid-show snack. Oh,
hey, mid-show snack.
Cake pop.
Sweet.
Thank you.
Okay, Trev, there you go. That's not going to last long with you. It's only one
thank
bite.
You. Thank you very much.
Hit me back, hey, Trev. Jesus.
Mm.
Yeah, I'll probably eat this quickly. Yeah, you're very insightful. Your barbs, oh, how they sting.
That's all I wanted.
I'm fucking three of you. Good Lord.
Yeah, I don't know why I keep pushing. I'm going to eat this now in three bites because I'm a human.
That's very tasty. Now we're all just eating on screen.
Yeah.
Oh, here. While we're eating, play that video, the Adam Sandler video that K-Trev put the link up for.
Oh, yeah, the Indiana Bigot.
Oh, I sent it to you.
Mm.
This is the woman, one of the women from the I Want to Punch.
We don't agree with it. It's offensive to us. I believe it was a choice that she made. I don't believe that they were born that way. I think that life circumstances made them choose that. I think God made everybody equal. I have kids come to me because of their sexual preference, and they know... I don't agree with it, but I care about you. And the same thing for special needs. You know, I don't understand it. A gay student or adult or person isn't going to come up and make some change unless it's because they realize, you know what, it was a choice and I'm choosing God.
Oh, we need a sword and a shield and we need to fight that fucking dragon.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point... In your rambling, incoherent response, were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought? Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, we slay the dragon. I say we all get our swords and shields, and we go to the lair.
All right, kids, we got to crush about 15, 20 more minutes.
And we take back Lonely Mountain.
Take back Lonely Mountain.
Yeah.
Yeah, what do you guys want to talk about now?
We got to crush 20 more minutes.
Yeah, man. We got to do it.
Oh, I got
to go back to sports.
No. We sported the
I got those girl fail videos.
I want to save those for the end, though. That's going to be a great way.
Oh, okay.
I just don't want to be a podcast that just watches videos the whole time.
Well, either way.
I'd like to save it. I don't know. That's just
where are you at this week? Where are you guys at this week? You touring? You touring?
Where am I? I'm going out east. Going out east. Going to Newfoundland. Going to Halifax. I'm going to be in Halifax for Pot Day.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
420?
420 in Halifax.
Hitler's birthday.
Oh, who here is going down to Dundas Square for 420?
That's right. If you are in town.
That's awful.
Come down, Young and Dundas Square, the 420
rally.
Celebrate
one of the worst human beings of all time.
We're not celebrating Hitler.
Yeah, whatever. It's like the worst day to pick to celebrate weed. It's Hitler's birthday. It's an awful fucking, like, it was a stoner oversight. Like, oh, man, I didn't know, man.
But we're not celebrating him.
Well, you can say what you want, but it looks bad.
I never even thought about it. Yeah. Never even gave it a thought.
Just saying. But you're celebrating it down. So
he's there in spirit.
Wearing tie dye with his little mustache.
You know what? I think I had it wrong.
Be a big rally, Young and Dundas Square. There'll be music. I know there's going to be comedy.
Are you going to go? Are you going to the?
Yeah, I'm going to be there. I'm going to be performing along with Brian O'Gorman.
There you go.
And Hunter Collins,
Mike Rita. Mike Rita. Yeah.
There you go. Yeah. Very pod-friendly group there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm going to venture down to the smaller version in Halifax, see what they're getting up to, which I imagine just smoking pot in the woods.
Yeah.
On the wharf.
Yeah.
They got a small group down there, but I'm going to go check them out, see what they're up to.
They'll be down there on the wharf.
Around the corner from the bar, probably. Yeah, well, that's all right. So you're going out and you're doing the rally next week, and I'm doing one-nighters and fucking Merlin.
Well, the rally's on the 20th.
Where are you next week?
This weekend I'm in Regina doing the Casino Regina.
Nice.
I'm there with Al Ray and Elvira Kurt and John Wing.
Woohoo! That'll be fun.
And then I'm off to the Winnipeg Fest immediately after that.
Yeah.
I'll see you there.
Yeah, I'll see you there. We will be in Winnipeg.
I'll be recording at Debaters in Winnipeg, which I still have to write. Yeah.
Going to Winnipeg. What, 450 words you got to put down?
Yep.
Difficult? What are you arguing?
I'm arguing natural medicine versus modern medicine with Darcy Michael.
Who are you?
I'm for modern medicine.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Ah. Yeah. But modern medicine can suck a dick.
That's probably what Darcy will say. Suck a dick. Suck
the pharmaceuticals, man. They're trying to just take your money. They want you sick.
Yeah. Well, that'll be all right. And you haven't written anything yet?
Oh, and I've written some stuff for it.
Yeah.
Essentially, I was a Christian Scientist. We did without any medicine for a long, long time.
Yeah.
And I can tell you that's a stupid idea.
Yeah. No doubt.
A good way to die is to not do anything to save yourself.
Yeah.
And frankly, I just trust doctors.
Yeah, well, no doubt.
I'm not going to lie to you. For the last couple of days, I've been just doing salad, trying to get healthy. So it's just been salad. And I don't know if it's the weed, but I don't feel strong right now.
No, of course.
I feel incredibly weak.
No, you need fucking protein.
Well, first of all, you were weak to begin with.
Yeah.
And then you started eating rabbit food only. And you probably have zero protein in your diet aside from it.
I got to change something up.
What'd you substitute it with? Would you?
I'm doing romaine lettuce with some kale.
What are you doing all the time for protein?
Oh yeah, I am shitting. What's that?
What are you doing for protein?
I do a couple of boiled eggs in the morning, and I'll maybe do a chicken. It's only been 2 days.
Okay.
I don't think I can last two more days. I'm not going to be a human.
You stopped drinking though, right?
Stop drinking.
Yeah.
Which, that's coming
fuck
back. That's
fucking
coming back.
Boo.
Yeah, fuck off.
By the way, boo.
Actually, I was out with Kate Davis on
Saturday.
No,
it's been hilarious
night. Watching
him drink tea at the bar.
Yeah. I'll have another tea, please.
Hey,
don't knock tea because I'm a big wimp.
I feel like fighting you when you drink tea.
Yeah. Is it the fact that my pinky's up? Is that what it is?
No,
is
it's just the fact that you're sitting there drinking tea. It's like, you want to drink tea? Go to a tea
house.
Now
for an edition of Punch a Guy Who Drinks Tea.
You're at an ale house. Have a fucking ale.
I was out with Kate Davis on Saturday after a show, and I got a double, and it was fantastic.
Oh, there you go.
I just had one, but it was fucking amazing.
One's all you need?
And then you said no to the rest.
I tried, yeah.
Yeah?
I'll be back.
You'll be back.
I'll be back. I'm always back.
Oh, well, that's good. That's good. Yeah. You guys had some serious life changes.
I've been thinking about some diet changes, but I'm fucking lazy.
Yeah, it's hard.
You know, and I keep shitty hours.
Yeah.
I think last night I had my last late night McDonald's for a while, though.
Oh, yeah, that hangover is something else, isn't it? Like the instant McDonald's hangover?
Yeah. Because the problem is it's right there.
Oh, yeah.
I live by Dundas West Station.
That's everyone's problem. They're always there. They built them everywhere.
I have to walk past it to get out of the subway.
Yeah.
Like, it's right there on my way home. And I generally, you know, I try not to eat before a show. So it's late at night, and I'm hungry. And just eating late at night is a bad idea.
And the fries smell so fucking good. You can't. It's hard to say no.
Yeah.
Those non-fry fries.
If anyone has ever said that they did not like McDonald's fries, they are lying.
Yeah, you're lying. You're a liar.
I did one of those. I went back, and I this is a because of this. This is why the salad thing happened. Because I watched a bunch of those Food Inc. docs.
Oh yeah.
Where how they treat animals.
Mm-hmm.
And, God, it's horrific.
Yeah.
Granted, we wouldn't have any of them. They wouldn't even exist if we didn't need to eat them so fast.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, they'd
be
all gone.
Bulldozers coming by and pushing, like, 8 cows into a room.
Well, how else are you supposed to get them in the room? Can't just go, hey, cows, go into a room. You need the bulldozer.
Yeah, you know, they're not very bright.
It's just so weird to see, like, cows bawling over each other like a fucking... It's just crazy.
Just little pieces of food in a little trail into a room. Oh, look, a little piece of food.
Ooh, piece of candy.
Slice across the neck.
Yeah.
And they put windows in their stomachs. It's got big, giant holes in the cow.
Mm-hmm.
Put a window in there so you can reach in and just grab anything you didn't want it to eat.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So it's all
which
that
is
corn
fucked
that
in the
it can't digest.
Does that hurt the cow? God, nah. Doesn't hurt the cow. Fuck you. It doesn't hurt the
it's
cow.
It's got a hole.
What you really should ask is, do you care if it hurts the cow?
Putting a food shunt
in
it.
Because the guy
who is cutting it up probably doesn't.
Yeah. Well, you know, and then the creepy genetic chicken things they're doing is just chickens with no heads.
They're trying to pass a bill in the States where food companies that clone food have to say it's cloned food.
Yeah.
I didn't even know they were doing that shit. And they're fighting against, like, oh, we don't want to tell people that it's cloned. Because they're flat out like they won't buy it.
I watched this TED talk about something similar. A guy wanted to clone animals that had gone extinct. Like, he wanted to bring back, you know, some extinct kind of pigeon, you know, or that...
Dodo?
Like this stuff that they have DNA, like the mammoth they have all that DNA for.
Tasmanian...
He wants to do Jurassic Park for real, though. Like, he was just like, fuck yeah. And he was trying to sell this idea at a TED Talks. And everybody's like, no, we've seen the movie. You know, it ends badly for everybody. Like, you can't... It's the worst... I can just show you this. After you do the talk, we'll show Jurassic Park. It's
yeah,
all,
yeah.
You know?
There's a
this
scientist...
This is my counterpoint. Steven Spielberg's Jurassic Park.
Yeah, Michael Crichton.
Pay special attention to when the fat guy from Seinfeld gets ripped apart by the spitting dinosaur.
Newman.
As long as they bring back Vigit. Nah, fuck it, not even.
What's that?
Yeah, there's a scientist that wants to bring back a Neanderthal.
Sweet.
They have enough DNA for a Neanderthal. They just are waiting for a woman to volunteer to have her pussy fucking destroyed.
She's got to be out there.
Just destroyed by this.
Just pay her.
Yeah, but that Neanderthal's not coming out nice.
Britney will do it. Britney Spears will do it. She'll birth a Neanderthal.
That thing's coming out of there with terror.
It's for America.
It's for America. America, fuck yeah.
Get Barbara
Bush.
What
do we need a Neanderthal for?
There's only one.
They think we can study it and it'll help us understand...
Yeah, but great. He's not gonna know shit about being a Neanderthal.
Right, and the Bills need a new running back.
That's what the Republicans need, more votes.
Yeah. Bunch of people that don't understand fire.
There's a guy who would punch lots of women right there. Neanderthal, man.
Oh, yeah.
Is it
unapologetically,
really?
Too. Like, what?
Is this like unfrozen caveman lawyer might actually happen?
Yeah, the Geico guy.
I just don't understand these flying birds. I'm a simple caveman. But what I do know is that my client is not guilty.
Wouldn't it be great if they cloned it and it came out a fucking alien? Boom! We were aliens.
Wow, we took a leap there.
Sorry. Jeez. Sorry, we don't
gleep
have to do
glurp de gleep.
Yep.
That, I think that's the plot to Cal's unpublished screenplay.
And boom, there's aliens.
They clone a Neanderthal. They grow him in a woman. But it's an alien. We're aliens the whole time.
Yeah. The more I think about it, I like that. I watch that.
Sounds like an Ed Wood movie.
And then I fuck it.
Yeah.
We're using all the first cuts. No practicing. But I met a character. Keep it.
I like it.
Roll film.
I like it. The more you talk, the more I'm sold.
Oh, yeah. Scientists and the crazy
just
fucking...
tick-tocking away here. Tick-tocking away.
We should do another 10 minutes. We really should.
Yep.
Well...
come up with a topic.
How's the corporate world?
Corporate? Well, there's not much. I got a couple of things going on later in the month. I'm doing a show for a bunch of cops.
You love that. You've done that before.
They party, man. They party. They treat you good, too, when you go in to do a show for them. And just nowhere else. So
Rob Ford going to be there?
I don't know. I've had Rob Ford show up at a show before, and that's just start handing out business cards while I was on stage. That's
weird.
A bit bizarre, yeah.
Like, hi, I'm the mayor. Here's my business card.
Job of the Hutt slugging around the room.
You know who you are.
Yeah. Yeah.
He looks like the bad guy from Captain Planet.
Wow, it's been a while. I can't believe you blew a cartoon reference by me either.
Yeah. Yeah, he was blue, right, Captain Planet?
Captain Planet, yes.
Yeah.
That's all I know. That's all I remember from that show.
Captain Planet, he's our hero. Gonna take pollution down to zero.
We're that awful. Starved
That's
for
probably
topics.
Where I stopped watching this right there. Throw my muffin wrapper out the window of the bus.
They all had the powers of the elements and heart.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
We could have a lot of fun right now and spoil Walking Dead for everybody.
Oh,
I haven't seen it.
Here, spoiler alert, it's terrible.
I'm a few episodes behind. I'm assuming the zombies got some people.
But which ones?
We're playing the season finale at the end of this show.
Are we?
Yeah.
Okay. Ooh. Oh, sorry, it's real good. Watch, it's good.
Yeah, I wasn't real pleased with the end of that season. It started out real strong. And then, like everything.
Yeah.
TV sucks.
TV does suck.
Except for The Wire, apparently, which I haven't seen.
Yeah, get on it, buddy. Grow up and watch The Wire.
That's worth watching.
Sure. I know everyone's seen it. I just have this thing when people are like, oh, you got to do something. I'm not doing it now that you said
you
I have to.
You guys see the new show Vikings?
No,
it's really good.
I haven't seen it, but I'm pissed off I did not read for it.
You'd be a good Viking.
I think so, too. What the fuck have I been growing this beard?
Well, the Vikings are just killing and raping and pillaging. A lot of them die, so it looks like they need characters.
Just you coming in every after scene, all winded. Did I miss the pillaging and raping? I always miss the pillaging and raping.
There's no rape in there. Not even a little bit of rape.
I got all turned around. I already pillaged this place.
Yeah. I got to pillage second, I see. can't get any pussy. You got to pillage first. Rape second. Yeah, I see why you're leading this tribe. Right on.
I'm intrigued by your teachings and would like to subscribe to your newsletter.
Right on. Making women love the podcast. Although guys at home.
I do believe if they make a Hagar the Horrible movie, that's the role I'm born to play.
Yeah? Hagar the Horrible? And you got to get your agent on that. You think
from the comic strips,
Canada?
You know. I think you put me in a fucking hat with horns on it. Fucking Hagar the Horrible right here.
Sweet.
Yeah, but you're hardly horrible. You smile, I think, more than anyone I know.
Hmm. It's a movie.
Are you that good an actor?
Did you see me play a murderer?
No.
Oh, I did.
I've never seen anything you do.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
No, I saw the TV show you did. Grocery one. Was it the grocery one?
Grocery?
I don't know. What was the show you did? You had like two seasons.
No, it was me. I was in a brick commercial.
Not a.
I was in Billable Hours.
Billable Hours. That's
I was
the
just
one. I got
a
confused
credits.
With another show that was on at the same time.
There was no groceries.
There was a grocery show that was on at the same time, and I just got them confused.
It's a show about lawyers.
Sorry, I'm just trying to help.
On an episode of The Border, I played a murderer.
Nice. Did you get to murder anybody?
Yeah.
Nice. Who'd you murder?
I killed. Killed one of the detective's son-in-laws while he was on the phone with her.
So he ended up dead?
Huh?
Did your character end up
dead? No, my character ended up arrested at the end.
Oh. Wow.
I walked up behind a guy when he was stopped at a road stop, and he was on his cell phone with his mother-in-law, and I came up behind him and put two bullets in the back of his skull.
Sweet.
While he was on the phone. So it just cuts to his mother-in-law, and she just hears two loud bang, and then no one's there
That
anymore.
Must have been so fun to shoot.
Oh, man, it was
I
awesome.
I want to shoot a gun again.
They gave me a 9mm Beretta, and it's like, this doesn't work, but it just feels so cool to have in my hand.
I've shot one. They're awesome. I enjoyed it.
I remember when we did that World War One movie with John Gardehouse, and then we had to pretend to shoot guns like when we were kids.
Yeah.
They gave us all these toy guns, basically, and we had to, like, pretend to shoot, you know?
My favorite was we were...
Not act. I don't know. You can call it acting as much as it was pretending.
Were you going, like, you're making noises?
No, we had... Well, we had the bolt-action rifles, you know? World War One. You had those... You had to cock it and...
We
and then aim and do all of that, but all just fake.
Yeah, all fake.
Even the bolts didn't come back.
Is that the one where O'Donnell kept eating?
Yeah. Tom O'Donnell kept eating.
That was, we played a troop from World War One, and it was all comics playing the troops. It was just the fattest, saddest group of soldiers that would have died 5 minutes into the war. As soon as we stepped out of the plane, all right, they were dead.
Yeah, dead.
Dead. We wouldn't have passed the physicals to go
war. No way.
Tom O'Donnell's a moron who I love.
Yeah, he was the funniest idiot I've ever met in my life.
Oh, he is such a...
idiot.
He means so well. Yeah. He's got such a big heart. There's just nothing going on in his... You look in his eyes.
No, he's slightly smarter than a cow and just a bit dumber than Homer Simpson.
Remember when we slapped the shit out of him at the Cottage Country Festival?
Played slap fight. We recommend you guys start slap
fight. Oh, you gotta start a slap fight.
It's a lot of fun.
If you don't know the rules of the slap fight, here they are. You slap a guy, and then at some other undetermined time in the future, he gets to slap you back.
And then you're even.
And then you're even. Or you can slap him back again.
And start it all over.
And start it all over.
Yeah.
So, we were playing that. We played it with Tom.
It gets carried away real quick.
Because the drunker Tom gets, his motor skills go right to shit.
Yeah.
So Tom's standing between me and Rob. And he's just standing there. He's not expecting anything. And I haul off from right beside him and just plow him in the face. And then as he turns to me, he looks at me with this, why would you do that? And before he even gets the thought through his eyes, Rob smashes him on the other side of the face. And then he turns with anger towards Rob. And even before his head finished turning, I smacked him again. It was three times he just took it and then lost it on you, chased you out into the parking lot.
Oh, I was giggling.
Chunky fist in the air.
So hard. Oh, it was the funniest thing. Had tears in my eyes, him chasing me around. And he was dancing around like the Fighting Irish guy with his fists all down here. Oh, God. Oh, God, that's just funny to watch guys
He was
lose
laid
it.
Out with a leg injury for a while because he had a...
Did he try to eat it?
Well, no, he had a... he had a similar kind
delicious.
Of... he was having a drunken night with one of his buddies, and they were fighting back and forth, and Tommy fucking sucker punched him at one point and was having a good laugh, and his buddy stood up and just dummied Tom, and he went out cold on his feet. And the way he fell, he broke his leg.
Oh, no.
Well, Tom's not... There's an argument to be said if he's even conscious when he is conscious. So to even say he knocked him unconscious is... Eh.
Yeah.
Knocked him out cold.
He can just fall over randomly like that at any given time, too.
Love to hand him a Rubik's Cube and play 2001 Space Odyssey.
He'd eat it.
How many of these stickers you got to peel off before I get the chocolate inside?
Just like an apple.
Yeah. Square plastic apple. Yum, yum.
Why are my fingers bleeding? This is hard to get open.
Right on.
All right, I think that's it.
I think we've done enough. To the finish line.
That was a lot of fun this week.
Everybody saddling in, getting ready to watch some zombie stuff.
Yeah, we got a big show. We have Walking Dead playing after the show. Anything you want to outro us with, K-Trev?
Folks, just once again a reminder to check out the 420 rally, Young and Dundas Square. There'll be a lot of people there smoking weed, fighting for freedoms and whatnot. And also check out JoannaDowney.com.
Oh, yeah, JoannaDowney.com. A fundraising event going towards Joanna Downey, who's been stricken with a terrible disease, Lou Gehrig's disease. So anything you guys
comedian who's lost her voice.
Yeah, which no greater scene, I don't
There's
think.
Yeah, probably nothing sadder.
Performer. To a performer, anyway.
To a comedian.
So that is our show. Thank you for tuning into the CK Podcast. Rob, thank you for coming.
Thanks
One
for
more time
me.
For our special guest, Rob Pue.
That was a lot of fun.
And once more, don't forget a happy birthday to Matt Oliver celebrating.
Happy birthday, Matt. Happy birthday. Sue me, fuckhead. Sue me!
And, of course, a round of applause for Chris Goodwin and Aaron Goodwin running the show, putting up the videos.
Thanks, Chris. Thank you for tuning in, everybody. Everyone at home, see you next week. Good night. CK Podcast. Boom! I'm going to smoke.
Very stretchy. So it came from the straight sizes. It's a size large. Holy crap! There was a spider on my face.
Gotta push, jump, push, and... Oh!
Six shot state for the bomb ass hippie. The state where you never find a dance floor empty. And pimp speed on a mission for them greens. Lean, mean, money making machines, serving fiends. I've been in the game for 10 years making cartoons. Ever since honeys was wearing Sassoon. Now it's 95 and they clock me and watch me diamond shining. Looking like a Rob Liberace. It's all good from Diego to the Bay. Your city is the bomb if your city making pain. Throw up a finger if you feel the same way. Straight put it down for California, yeah.
Black precious cuff, a new millennium dime piece, wine sheet. On the Diaz.
Go! Let's get out of here. Oh.
Pete.
Müssen wir eine Rede halten? Das kann ich mir gleich geben, ich ziehe mich da gleich sofort raus.
Warte, ich filme das Wasser, warte. Eis hier überall.
Ja, egal, überall rein.
In der Mitte am besten da.
Ja. Ich will nicht mal gucken, nicht, dass es zu hart ist.
Nicht drauf?
Ja.
Motherfucker, fuck the fucking world and my new band is called Siskill. Oh mein Arsch! Oh, ich muss die ganze Runde.
Oh, sie ist kill.
Oh mein Arsch! Oh, ich muss die ganze Runde.
It's an equation from hell.